Hey, what's up guys? It's Ivan, and in this video I'm going to show you exactly how to set up Google Tag Manager on your website step by step. This tutorial is actually a part of my online marketing blueprint course where I walk you through the entire A to Z of online marketing. In this particular section, we focus on conversion tracking and how to install essential tools like Google Analytics, Google Tag Manager, and so on. So let's get straight into it. What is Google Tag Manager and why are we using it? So Google Tag Manager is a tool provided by Google that contains all the code that is added to your website. So it's a really very convenient tool, and the beauty and the benefit of Google Tag Manager is that it contains all the code that you need from different sources inside this one container. So once we start adding code from, let's say, Facebook ads or Google ads or analytics to our website, we don't have to go in and log into our website every time and change the code for each different application. We can do that all in one place, Google Tag Manager. So it's a super easy, super efficient way to manage every code on your website, or at least every relevant code that we're going to be adding from the different tools and applications that we'll be using. In addition, Google Tag Manager has some very sophisticated and advanced options for creating events and tags that we're going to be sending off into Google Analytics. So it's an amazing tool that we're going to be able to use to our advantage to set up and manage the codes for our site. So let's go in there and let me show you how to set that up.
So let me show you how to set up the Google Tag Manager, the very, very first step in this entire process. So you can go to Google and type in Tag Manager, and likely it'll be the first result, or you can just type in tagmanager.google.com. And then you're going to see a page that looks like this, so we're just going to fill in the blanks. So our company name, Dynamic Growth Agency, enter your country. If you want to be generous and share data with Google, you can do so here. Now here you have the account and the container. So Google Tag Manager, same as Google Analytics, has an account structure where you have the account level at the top for your business, and then for each different website or unrelated product, you're going to have a container. So we just have the website, so we're just going to type that in, dynamicgrowthagency.com. And then if later on you have another app or you have another product or another website, you can add new containers to your account. So we're going to select web. We're going to click on create. We are going to agree to the terms because we have no other choice. And there you go. So now it's telling us we need to install the codes on the site. So we need to put this in the head section and this in the body. So thankfully with Elementor, we have that covered in terms of the code. So we don't need to install any other plugins. So we're going to go to Elementor custom code over here. We're going to click on add new. We're going to grab this head code over here. We're going to make sure the location is set to head. We're going to paste the code and we're going to name this GTM and we'll just say head. We're going to publish. And then we want this to be on the entire site. So we'll click save and close. And then we're going to click on add new. We're going to come here. We're going to copy the body tag. We're going to paste it here at the start. Notice how they're telling you put it immediately after the opening body tag, right? So we want to put it at the start, not at the body end. So make sure you select that. Then we'll say here GTM and we'll say body and we're going to publish. And again, we want this to be on the entire website, no exceptions, because we will be able to specify the exact URLs later on in terms of the conversion and event tracking. So just make sure to put it on the entire site and then we can customize and tailor from there. So let's click on custom code. Let's make sure we have both of these added right here. So now if we need to change anything, if we need to add a new ID or something like that, we can just come in here and edit it. But we won't have to touch this anymore. Every other change that we do now in terms of integrations with other apps or products like Google Analytics or Google Ads or Facebook Ads, so on and so forth, we're going to be doing inside of Google Tag Manager. So now that we've added that, let's enter our URL in here and confirm that it has been added successfully. We're going to click test. And there you go. So let's click OK. And so now that's good. So if you, for some reason, exited out of those instructions and you can't find them anymore, just click over here at the top and you should be able to pull it up again. Alternatively, if you go to admin and you go to install Google Tag Manager, you'll see the code here as well. So don't worry about all these options here. I will go over them as we navigate through the rest of the module. But right now, what we want to do is submit. Now, in general, the rule of thumb is before we publish any changes, we're going to preview and we're going to make sure that it's set up and working.
But I do want to cover preview and the debug view in another video, and the change we made here is super, super basic. We're just installing GTM, so we can hit submit over here. So it's a very good practice to at least enter a descriptive name. That way, when you see your version history, you will be able to see the exact changes that you made. You don't have to click on the specific version to see what the changes were that you made. So over here, we can say, for example, added GTM. You could add a description if you want to, but for basic things like this, that's just an overkill. So we're going to hit publish. And now we can come in here and we can see that very first change we made, added GTM. So right at a glance, we'll be able to see all the version history over here and we will know what does what. And then if you want to go back to any version, if you make any mistake or something like that, you just select it and click on publish.
And that is all. Hopefully this helped you successfully set up Google Tag Manager on your website. If you found value in this tutorial and want to learn more, I invite you to check out my website at ivanmana.com, where you can get free starter access to the course and also see what the full training is all about. That is all for this video. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next one.